doesn't say. When we go on the show, when he walks out on that stage, I don't care what he says. I don't believe a word out of his mouth. I don't trust him. He's out of control and he creates chaos wherever he goes. I regret the day that we went to Santa Cruz and adopted Adam. If Karen and I would have just passed the hospital and went over to the Humane Society and picked up a couple of strays, we would have been much better off.
Well, on the other hand, Karen believes with everything in her heart that there is just something wrong with Adam. She refuses to give up on her son.
I can't fix Adam. I've taken my son for medical evaluations. I have a psychiatrist saying he's bipolar, and then I have another psychiatrist saying he's not. I don't know. I've moved him into 4 rehabs. I've done everything possible. I am grasping at straws. Tim wants to wipe Adam out of our lives. And I can't do that. I'm Adam's mother. I can't force a relationship between Adam and Tim. I've separated myself from that a long time ago because it's harmful to everybody. What I want for Adam is to have peace. At the end of the day, I will always forgive Adam because I love him. I can't write him off, but if I have to remove him from this environment, I know that I have to do that.
All right, well, I'm glad to meet y'all. You're done.
Done. Yep. 3 years ago, I was done.
Yeah. When you said, "I wish I had never adopted him," most of the audience just recoiled. They're just like, "Oh my God, that is."
This is a living hell.
What kind of parent could say that?
No. This. Let me tell you. I was a police officer for 30 years, and I've dealt with a lot of issues. And when I look at this kid, to me, he was. When he went to college, we lost him. My focus now goes to my wife.
Because you said, in all candor to us, you said, "I'm coming to the show, but I am not coming to fix my relationship with him. I am coming to help her turn loose, to help her let go."
Exactly.
That's what
you're
here for. You don't want to have some kumbaya with Adam because you wouldn't believe it?
He's going to lie to you. Let him come out. He's a manipulator.
You say he's an animal that belongs in a cage.
Absolutely. The only thing I think right now.
You're talking about your son.
My son, Adam. I mean, I'm not a doctor, but I know enough that this kid needs to be in a controlled environment. He cannot be out in an apartment or someplace roaming around. It doesn't work.
Your husband says about your son, quote, "I don't care if he's sleeping behind a gas station."
Yeah.
Okay?
Yes.
How do you feel?
Well, nobody wants their child sleeping behind a gas station. I mean, clearly, I'm a mother first. You don't want that for your child ever. But I will tell you that last week, before I wrote your show, that... Adam called my husband and I screaming, raging, because we would not get him a flight home. He didn't want to drive 8 hours back to go back down to San Diego. And I emphatically said, absolutely not. That right at that moment, I realized I can't do any more for this child, this young adult. I have to replace child with young adult because he is 24 years old. And Tim and I have often talked about me thinking about Adam, the young pictures that you see. And I have to think of him as an adult, that he is able to make his own choices.
Do you care about this connection here?
Yes, yes, absolutely.
I guarantee you this much. No matter what this jackass pulls, nothing's going to come between the two of us. That will never happen.
We're going to take a break, and then he's going to come out. Our Twitter is blowing up right now. NPR mommy says, "Stop calling him this kid. Like it or not, he's your son." At Healed Heart says, "Dad, you can't give up on him. That is not an option. Now he needs you more than ever before." And D.H. TaylorMade says, "Never give up on your child, adopted or not. He's your son, always will be. Get him the help he needs."
Give him the help he needs? We've given him every single thing this kid needs in the last 6 years.
Well, obviously not, because it hasn't helped. I mean, there's something he needs that you haven't
given. Yeah, he needs to bottom out. Somewhere along the line, he needs the safety net pulled out from under him where he can then go, "Wow, I've got a problem. I need to move on with my life."
That's Dr. Tim's analysis. Dr. Phil's may be different. I don't know. I haven't met him yet. I might agree with you. Next, Adam is here and places a lot of blame for his downward spiral. Guess what? On his parents. We'll talk about that when we come back.
I don't think Adam is suicidal. He said he took 30 pills and it actually turned out to be like maybe 8 of them. And he's told me, "I just want to say sorry and goodbye, Dad." Well, he didn't go anywhere. It's like, okay, I'm trying to kill myself, but not really. It's complete manipulation.
Adam admits he's angry, hostile, and simply